Thank you for joining, and in this video we are going to cover splines. So the splines are most powerful and complex entities in Solidworks. So let's see how spline works. So for that I can go into a plane and then I can start sketch. So here in the toolbar of sketch and in the ribbon of sketch toolbar, you can see there is an option for the spline. So in the spline there are three types of spline. One is spline, one is style spline, and third one is equation driven curves. So we are going to cover spline and style spline. So for the simple spline, I can choose a spline. What I can do is I can just start from a point and I can go and I can end at a point. But still look, the command is still on, but if you want to turn off the command, so you can just press the escape key at any time. So might be you are thinking it looks like a regular line command, but it's not a line. So let's click on the spline. And you can see there are multiple points. So what I can do is I can just change the shape. And there are some direction vectors. So by using these direction vectors, I can just change the shape. So I have a freedom to move. I can extend in this way or I can bring back into this way. It's up to me. Okay, so there is another thing. We can hold this point and we can change the angle as well. At what angle you want to bend this line. Same in this way. Again, we can bend and then we can just change the angle. And we can just float it anywhere, wherever we want. Then I'm gonna go back and just press the green check mark. Okay, so I want to go back into the style spline. So in the style spline, this is a bit simple and advanced. So what you can do is you just need to draw the points. First point, second point, third point, and fourth point. And press the escape key. Okay, so you can see in the simple spline, you can see you can control the direction by only using these direction vectors. So in this way, sometime maybe the shape can be feared or somehow you did not have a lot of control in that things. But here in this command, in this style spline, you can see like you can hold the point and you can slowly bend wherever you want. So this is just a small bend. So it's just a free floating spline and you can control, or you can just hold this side and you can move them. So in this way you have a more control on the shape. So but in the simple spline we have some kind of limitations. Sorry for distraction, but if you think my videos are helpful for you, or if you are a serious SolidWorks learner, then I am going to highly recommend you can go into the description of this video and you would found a link of my course where I have over 10 hours of videos in which I have explained each and every command in a very detailed video. Or if you have any projects or assignments, so feel free to write me on my email, which is given into the description of this video. Thank you. So this is a spline, but I just want to mention a point here. So in the simulation or in the software, it works really nice, but there are some limitations whenever you want to move the design to the manufacturer, because these things are possible in simulations in the software, but not everything is possible in the lab or at the manufacturer. So that's why there are some limitations and you have to keep in your mind. But there is another thing which we can do, like if we already have this spline, what we can do is we can just select this spline and we can convert into construction geometry. So this is moved, this is converted into the construction geometry, and then we can go, we can just take a 3-point arc, we can start this 3-point arc. We can just put it here and then we can just follow it, or we can just go and we can take a tangent arc. We can start from point to point. Okay, I can press escape. So in this way, we are just using the spline just for the drawing. But we already made a 3-point arc. So in this way, I can have a dimensions for these arcs. So for this point, I have a dimension. For this point, I have a dimensions. Okay, for this point, I have a dimension. So in this way, at least I have some values, I have some readings which I can mention into my drawing if I want to send it to the manufacturer. So this is a way like we can just use spline for the guidance, like just to design, just for the as a guidance for our design, and then we can just use 3-point orgs or tangent org or whatever. So this is a good solution for these kind of problems.
And that's all for today's video. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this one. And if you are a serious SolidWorks learner, then don't forget to check the course link in the description. Thank you.